song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I ever adore. In other words, please be free. In other words, I love you.
Turn that racket off! I'm trying to watch the racing! Will you pass me the ruddy clicker?
What's all this fuss? Don't forget your tablets.
Oh, no wonder I'm ill. I mind the drugs they feed me.
Oh, remember what Dr. Fenton said about positive mental whatnot? They want to see you back on your feet and these will help you get there.
What's making you so happy prancing around like a fat fool?
And you've forgotten. It's my class tonight.
Oh.
Don't be like that. It's the special session. I told you all about it. There's me and two other ladies trialling for the intermediates.
You'll be lucky you'll hardly think like you.
We talked about it. Happening classes twice a week?
Two nights a week? One's bad enough. What am I supposed to do on my own?
Like you said, it's highly unlikely I'll get picked. Great elephant like me.
Ah, sorry for dragging you in so early.
No worries, I'll part of the service.
You'll be wanting a tip next. Anyway, Havley seems lucid enough. As soon as you sign him off, I can get on with the interview.
Right, one step at a time, yeah.
Yeah, Moore. I'm Ronnie Woodson, solicitor representing Quinn Haverley.
Morning, Mr. Woodson. We were just about to deal with Quinn.
Oh, really? I'd be interested to hear why your dealings with my client seem to have marked him out for special interest. Why was Quinn kept overnight when the others were released?
I'm sure you don't need reminding, Mr. Woodson. The possession of cannabis is an offence.
Our client was only carrying enough for personal use. I suggest that being kept in a cell overnight was unnecessary.
Your client should be happy I don't have him for resisting arrest, as well as drug offences.
With Quinn being both stoned and injured, we agreed that he shouldn't be questioned until the morning.
Now, if you let me get on, I'll get your client out of here as soon as possible.
My client's mother, Alex Haverley, has reason to believe that her son has been the subject of unwarranted police attention over the last year, including one case of wrongful arrest.
Alex Haverley, Councillor Haverley from the Police Consultative Committee.
That's right. So, if you'll excuse me while you assess Quinn, I'm going upstairs to make a formal complaint to the Chief Superintendent.
That's this Thursday, the 25th.
Lou?
Well, just look at you. You look amazing.
Thank you. I just got a gold star from Dr. Fenton.
Well, I'm not surprised. There won't be anything left of you at this rate.
Oh, there's still more than enough of me. Just less than there was. It's difficult not to snack when you're stuck at home.
Yeah. So how has your dad been then since these strokes?
Not so bad, really. He's still immobile down his left side, but, you know.
Yes, well, he would make a saint reach for the hobnobs at the best of times.
The dancing keeps me on the straight and narrow.
Dancing?
Ballroom and Latin. I've been doing it a few months now. I recommend it to anyone, particularly when you need a bit of cheering up. Why not come along? It keeps me fit and you meet such nice people.
Oh, yeah? Tell me more.
Actually, there's a taster session this lunchtime, if you fancy it.
A very nice change of subject, but I don't think so, thanks. I don't think the cha-cha is quite me.
Oh, rubbish. I bet you look lovely in one of those big frocks.
It'd be such a treat to have some moral support. I usually have to go on my own.
Oh, all right then. You've twisted my arm.
We're in the village of Leland here, just a couple of miles from St. Ives. Get inside, have a look around, and we'll be listening on the headphones out here.
Lovely.
Tell us what you think. This is a bit of a good place. It's a nice big kitchen, isn't it?
Get back to work. And your mum's going to be anxious about you. Do you know him?
No. I think he was in the bar last night. Just some lowlife.
Well, you might want to consider hanging out with a different crowd.
Yeah, you're right. Thanks for everything you've done.
No, it's the least I could do. Now, try and do your mum a favour and stay out of trouble. She's got enough to worry about.
I only bought the stuff for a party. Everyone does it. Except when I did it, I get caught. I should have known.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Oh, not so fast. I promised your mum I'd get you back to the farm.
Great. Cheers.
I take it you weren't invited upstairs for tea and cakes?
Try humble pie. Apparently I've been overzealous.
Well, what does that mean for Quinn?
Well, it means he gets to skip home with a caution like the rest of them. I mean, how was I to know his mum was some bigwig? I wasn't even around when all that kicked off.
Oh, yeah, you missed out. Well, it's not every day that a superintendent gets exposed for corruption. It went all the way from Squires up to Jackson. Ronnie did a lot of the whistleblowing. He was the hero of the hour, I dare.
He's obviously got the ear of the super. Meanwhile, I've still got a dodgy drug out there.
And you sure it was strike those kids were on?
Should know in the next hour or so. But if it is, it'll take more than friends in high places to stop me bringing Haverley back in.
After you.
What's taking you so long? I've been stuck here waiting for help.
Well, I'm back now. Just in time to get your 11s. Dr. Fenton was really pleased with my weight. He says I'm right on target. I've made you an appointment to see him this Thursday.
I don't need anything else from him. I'm on enough pills already.
I've got to pop out again at lunchtime. Not for long.
What now? You've been out all day.
I need to pick up your prescription.
I've got my prescription. What are you up to?
I promised to take Julia to the community centre. She's interested in dancing.
Dancing? I need you here with me.
I won't be gone long. You'll hardly miss me.
I can't thank you enough. I know if Colin were here, he'd have felt the same.
No, don't mention it. Sorry I couldn't do anything last night.
Well, it's hardly your fault. And as for you, haven't you had enough hassles with the police?
Sorry, Mum. I didn't mean to embarrass you like this.
Yeah, well, you might have considered that before using this stupid stuff. Gonna have something to eat. Oh, you smell worse than those pigs you're about to muck out.
Don't be too harsh on him. An evening in one of those cells is a sobering experience for anyone.
I've always worried my position might make us a target. Having friends we can trust, like you and George, it makes all the difference.
Just to get Dad settled. I'm afraid I can't stay long. I don't want him kicking up a stink and stopping me coming tonight.
Why, what's happening tonight?
A long shot, really. I'm trying out for a place in the group above.
Good for you! I didn't realise you were such an expert at this.
Hardly. Anyway, that's why I need to keep Dad sweet.
Don't let him rule your life, Lou. Caring for somebody at home doesn't mean you've got to give up everything.
I know, but I owe him so much. He was lying there 24 hours before anyone found him. So awful. That's when I made the decision to move back home. It's his turn now.
Don't you think you've done enough already? It's not everybody that would give up their job and move here.
I thought I saw him move his left leg the other day. I felt so relieved. It was just wishful thinking. He's completely helpless.
Honestly, Lou, you make it sound as if it's your fault. Nobody could do more for him than you do.
Come on. We're up. You're going to love this. The cha-cha-cha. You're a natural.
Pills. You shouldn't leave a sick man on his own like this.
Well, that should be the end of the matter. Well, Quinn's not stupid. I don't think he's going to do this again in a hurry.
You're too forgiving. If he's going to hang out with a crowd like that, he's asking for trouble. Well, what is wrong with him?
They all do it these days. What mystifies me is why the police came down so hard on him. Usually it's just a rap knuckle and confiscation. Well, yeah, perhaps it is victimisation.
Yeah, I can believe that. Well, the committee and I have ruffled plenty of feathers down at the station.
You shouldn't put up with it.
What with a farm, a house, my health? Do you know, I've got enough on my plate right now. Besides, I'm the last to pretend that Quinn's an angel, and these run-ins with the police, they never come to anything.
Well, bear it in mind. I'm always here if you need me. The last thing you want right now is bullying from the police.
I've got to go. Dad just rang. He sounds distressed. He really does. He's here.
Who is?
Tim. He's in the intermediate class. He's terribly good at the quick step.
Oh, yes, I can see the attraction of the intermediate class.
Hello there. I was hoping I'd find you here. I wanted to wish you good luck for tonight.
I'll need more than luck. Places for us ladies are like gold dust.
Yes, but you've done the work, and I've seen you dance. In fact, I was hoping you might let me partner you this evening for the tryout.
I really couldn't.
Think of a better offer.
You'd be thrilled, wouldn't you, Lou?
It's all right, I'll come with you. Pick you up at 5:45.
If anyone has any information that might help them with their investigations into the death, they should call Crime Stoppers. The number is 08000-555-111. That number again, 08000-555-111.
Yes, and that was the second of Peter's special reports on the prison service. Tomorrow we ask, can you change people's hearts and minds?
Therapists for
no!
Are they holiday camp sessions or life-changing courses?
Still to come on today, Dan's at a sporting spectacular where a world record could be broken.
It's the little boys' game that's been taken over by the big boys. The two cities conquered cop has come to Birmingham.
I'll have the details later on.
Thanks very much, Dan. System riding disabled children with equipment is on the verge of collapse, and 250,000 youngsters have also affected.
That's what a Midlands-based charity is saying today at the start of a new campaign. Here's Liz Copper.
Funding for disabled equipment does come from many different sources, and this issue doesn't just affect Stoke-on-Trent.
I'm just leaving. Is there any news?
The lab report shows that the weed that Haverley and Co. had on them was definitely not Stripe. It was the street norm.
Well, we all make mistakes.
No, this isn't a mistake, it's a mess. Something just isn't right.
Dad! Are you all right? What happened?
I'm okay.
You're not okay. Stay right where you are. I'm going to ring for an ambulance.
No, I'm okay. I was desperate for the loo and you were so late.
I'm sorry, Dad, this is all my fault. Shall I call Dr. Fenton?
No, we don't need any doctors. They'll stick me back in the hospital all on my own. I'm much better off here with you. Just don't run away again.
I'm not going to. Let's get you in your wheelchair. Are you sure you're okay?
All I need is a nice cup of tea. Some quality time with my daughter.
I'm not going anywhere.
Promise?
Promise.
You look tired. It must be tough work at the station.
It works fine. It's the politics that does my head in. Interference.
I know how he feels. Julia, there's a message for you from Lou Hastings. She said she can't make dancing tonight. She's got a problem with her father.
Yeah, I bet there is. Did she say anything else?
That's it.
So, how did you get on at the dancing? Anyone make a move on you?
Well, one of us found the ideal partner, and it certainly wasn't me. Vivian, I'm going to have to go early this evening. There's something I've got to do.
Here you go, Dad. The sooner you swallow this, the sooner I'll bring in your supper.
You're a good girl.
What have you got on your telly tonight? Were you expecting anybody?
You ready?
Didn't you get my message?
What message?
Dad's had a fall. I can't possibly leave him. Oh, I'm sorry you came all this way.
You missed a bit. So does Tim know that you're not going tonight?
I don't have his number. I guess that's over and done with.
Well, I didn't have you down as somebody who'd give up that easily. Can I come in?
I'm just preparing Dad's supper.
Oh, now I'm here, might as well say hello to him.
I'm not sure. I don't want him upset any more today.
For heaven's sake, Lou, he's known me for years.
Look, Dad, you've got a visitor.
Not more health workers.
Bill, long time no see. We missed your racing reports.
I'll just be in the kitchen.
So, Lou told me about your fall. You sure you're okay? Because I can easily get one of the doctors to come round and check you out.
No, I'm fine.
You look well. Actually, you both do. Don't you think Lou's done really well on a diet? I mean, I suppose the dancing's helped. Honestly, she's a different person. Anyway, I was thinking it'd be a really great shame for her to miss this opportunity tonight, so I thought, why don't I stay here with you and then Lou can pop out and do her class, what do you reckon?
She put you up to this, didn't she? She's always looking for ways to leave me.
Bill, that is a really terrible thing to say. She would do anything for you, you know that. Look, listen, I'm talking to you.
Oh, give me that! Oh.
Bill, that arm looks pretty useful to me.
Oh, I've got a little feeling back. I didn't want to tell Lou till I was sure. I want to surprise her when I can walk properly again. Do you think I like being a burden to her? She'll go off and I'll lose her again.
Well, what you're doing is the surest way to make that happen. You know, the happier Lou is in Leatherbridge, the better it is for both of you. Besides, she deserves to know the truth.
Grub's up!
You look like you've had one of those days.
I have. I spent the morning trying to stop the new DI and her medical sidekick from sticking Quinn in the stocks. They have no regard for how much distress it causes.
How's Alex doing? She didn't look too good yesterday.
Well, she was all right, actually, considering her son spent the night in custody. It'd be enough to stress any mother. Jimmy only pronounced Quinn fit this morning.
Well, I suspect he's taking his new job very seriously. It's just a shame that Alex is on the receiving end.
Yeah, well, it's at times like this that she needs all the friends she can get.
Don't you need to be getting off soon?
What do you mean?
I thought you had your class tonight. Some big audition, you said.
I told you, Dad. I'm staying here with you this evening.
Well, I think you should go, seeing as they're expecting you.
Just forget all about the audition. I have.
I'm feeling much better. It would be a shame for you to miss your chance.
Look, I really appreciate your concern, but I've made up my mind. I can't commit to dancing twice a week, so what's the point of auditioning?
Will you stop your rabbiting and get your kit together? You'll be late otherwise.
When will you have your bath, then? I'll ring later. Very good, sir.
I'm so sorry, Lou. I thought that was supposed to be a blooming shortcut.
There's no partners left.
And where's Prince Charming?
Dancing with Susan Morris. She's trialling this evening. It doesn't matter. I'm not auditioning anyway. Let's go.
Not so fast. You give up too easily.
Dad? How did you get here?
In a taxi. How else? Your mother could jive rings round these scrawny old birds. I bet you can too.
Didn't know you two danced.
Oh, we cut quite a dash down the dance hall. I wasn't always a grumpy old man. You're going to stand there gawing, or are you going to dance with your father?
But are you going to tell me what's going on?
I owe you an apology. I thought if I told you I was better, you'd leave.
What? Has it never occurred to you I like helping you at home? It makes me happy, just as dancing does.
Really?
Really. It doesn't have to be one or the other. I'm just glad you're on your feet again.
Hey, you got a minute?
Yeah, just catching up with paperwork. Not enough hours in the day.
Got a lot on, it must be difficult for you.
Nothing I can't handle. How's Quinn?
He's all right. A bit shaken up, I suppose. It's a shame he had to be kept in last night.
Listen, it was my job to assess whether he was fit or not for interview, and in my judgment, he wasn't. Leave me out the politics.
Well, they come with the territory, I'm afraid. It's very easy to get drawn in and then end up with egg on your face.
Thanks for the advice. I've got to get on.
Given up on you. I was just standing in for Susie's husband. Do you mind if I have the next one?
Well, I'm waiting for you, dozy mare.
The others don't stand a chance.
That's my girl. She looks like her mum. Andrew and I used to dance every Saturday night down the Ritz. It's where we met. Before I got so old and useless.
Not so old and not so useless. Besides, you've got a daughter that's devoted to you.
Can't think why. I bullied Lou just like I did Angela. But you knew Angie. She gave as good as she got. Lou's a soppy old goat. Takes after her father.
What did you think?
I think that teacher would be daft not to promote you.
She did, but I've turned them down.
You go back to that teacher and tell them to expect you twice a week from now on.
Are you sure?
Yes. Looks like your Fred Astaire is looking for his ginger. Go on, then.
Mr. Tupper asks if he might have the honour of this dance. He's taken rather a fancy to you.
May I?
Yes, of course.
Oh, sorry. I thought I was the last one standing. Okay.
Well, if you've come to continue Ronnie's round, I've had enough for one day.
Oh, no, he's safely ensconced at home with our daughter. I heard the pair of you locked horns today at the station.
Yeah, well, when I applied for this job, I had no idea I needed to be a politician as well as a doctor.
We'll just try and understand where he's coming from. You know, the Haverleys are good friends of ours, and Quinn's just lost his dad, his mum's suffering with angina. This business isn't good for either of them.
And I'm sorry to hear that, but I do have to do my job. To be honest, it doesn't sound as if I'm the one being partisan here.
I beg your pardon?
Look, let's just leave it to the police, shall we? I'm sure DMO knows what she's doing.
Well, let's hope she does, because people's lives have been affected here.
What do you think? We don't know that. Look, I'm fed up with people trying to tell me how to do my job. I'm stuck in here after hours doing the best that I can.
Just bear it in mind. That's all I'm asking.
Right, and now you've asked, so if you'll excuse me, I would like to get home.
That you are just the doctor.
I'm guessing it didn't belong to them either. They wanted it pretty bad. Someone took a harmless old man and beat him so hard, his heart stopped.
Dan's tempted by a job offer in Holby City tonight at 8. But next on BBC One, can you spot the dirty, rotten cheater?